excited for this segment because I'm really, truly passionate about this, and you're going to be too, I promise. You probably maybe have your veggie garden planted, but what about your pollinator garden? Well, Noelle Aiken from Petiti's Garden Center is here to teach us everything we need to know about pollinator gardens that are getting bigger and bigger every year.
Yes.
And first of all, I love your earrings, little butterflies.
Thank you.
Which are very appropriate for this segment.
That's right.
Let's talk about pollinators. And if you didn't understand the scope of how important this is, give us this statistic because it will blow your mind.
Right. So one out of every three bites of food you take is due to pollinators. So
amazing.
That is how vital pollinators are. I mean, if we don't have pollinators, we don't have food, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah, absolutely.
So when you think, I don't want bees in my yard, I mean, who doesn't want butterflies and hummingbirds
right?
and other birds,
yeah.
right? But we need to have these flowers outside.
Absolutely.
We need to have these critters that we're attracting to our homes
For
and
sure.
all over.
Yes, yes.
So let's talk, how do we draw these beautiful butterflies, bees, mm-hmm. Birds, all that good stuff?
Right, so you always want to supply them with a diverse planting, okay? And we use annuals, trees, shrubs, perennials, herbs, even some weeds, you know, if you leave some weeds go, it's
like
okay.
Dandelions.
Like dandelions.
I mean, we always see bees on dandelions,
yes,
right?
Yes, they love dandelions. They love clover. So those types of things are really, really good for them. And that diverse food source. So they need pollen, they need nectar, and all different types of plants. So that's always going to help them in the long run.
I love it. All right, so we're looking at a lot of beautiful flowers right now. Some video of some wild flowers, too, that are out there. But if you want to bring some, look at that adorable little hummingbird.
Right.
So let's talk about this. This is fascinating. You were telling me about this a little while ago. It's gorgeous because I said, is that a daisy?
And it is. It's an annual sunflower, but it's a repeat blooming sunflower. It's called Sunfinity. And it's just one of those cool breeding, you know, types of effects where now you have a sunflower that can bloom all through your growing season.
Because I didn't know sunflowers will do the one beautiful pop and then you have to reseed them every year, right?
Yeah, right. So sunflowers don't last very long in the fields, and it's usually just one nice flower, and then
I
you know,
love this. It's
gone.
Gorgeous,
yeah.
Gorgeous.
And daisies, any type of daisy. So when you see like a marigold, marigold's in the daisy family.
Okay. Oh.
Zinnias, Bidens, any type of daisy. This is a perennial aster.
That's so pretty, purple.
Yeah. So anytime you see a daisy, it's going to be a great flower for pollinators. The bees love them. The birds love them, and absolutely the butterflies love them.
Oh,
so
beautiful.
Anytime you plant a daisy,
what's
it's
this
great.
One here?
Uh-huh.
This guy.
This is a red cardinal flower.
That's this one.
This is a native plant, and I should mention native plants are great for pollinators too, but so are non-natives. But they're really good for native plant material is really good for pollinators. And this red cardinal flower, of course, has those red tubular flowers, and the hummingbirds absolutely love that for sure.
Yeah. It really attracts them. I mean, it
it
really
does.
Truly
yes.
does.
Any reds or oranges really brings them into the garden.
The butterflies more?
Hummingbirds.
Hummingbirds.
And butterflies like bright colors too. So yeah, absolutely. Those bright colors will work for them. The kind of softer colors, the blues, the purples, the whites, the yellows, that's really good for the bees. So combination of colors really is great too.
Yeah, and it looks so beautiful. All right, so what else? What is this here?
Coneflower. So you have coneflowers in all different colors now. Of course, the birds love the seed on the top, but the butterflies will land on this. The bees will check them out as well. So there's lots of little flowers right in the center, and that's what they're going for, that nectar, that pollen that they produce, for sure.
Oh, so nice. Put them by your windows so you and your cats can enjoy all the animals. That's what I do at my house.
For sure.
So we're looking at the pollinator garden, some more information there as we kind of move along to some more of these great
butterfly
flowers.
Weed and milkweed, these are really, really important plants, of course. They help the monarch. So if you're really focused on just growing plants for monarchs, you need to have your butterfly weed and your milkweed in the garden for sure. Because that's all that they consume. That's their main host plant. And so you need those, absolutely.
Wow. Real quick, and we're being told to wrap, but just generalize what we've got over here.
Yeah, butterfly bush, coreopsis, more daisies, yarrow, lavender, fresh smelling plants. This is bee balm. This is in the mint family. So it's going to have a great fresh smell, and the bees absolutely love it. In fact,
that smells so good.
Yeah. So again, those fresh smells, wonderful, wonderful, especially for butterflies and for bees. They love that.
So neat. Go to Petites. You're out and about at all of the stores,
yes.
Mostly in Oakwood Village.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have any questions about pollinators and what would be great for you and your yard, ask them, because they're so great with that. You guys really helped me out kind of getting up on my pollinators,
great.
Too. And I love it. So cool.
Thank you.
Noelle,
thank
great
you
to
so
see
much.
You. Appreciate it. Tell everyone at Petites we said hi.
Absolutely.
Those guys.